It was the right call because after consulting with independent field experts, as well as their own and those of the NFLPA, they decided that after all the rain and all the events that they had at Estadio Azteca recently, soccer games and a Shakira concert, that it was just going to be too dangerous for the players involved. And it was going to lead to a lower quality of play in what should be a really good game between two of the NFL's elite teams. Now, the Rams had decided to train in Colorado all week to get used to the altitude of Mexico City. They're going to stay there. They're hoping maybe it'll be a bonding experience for them, then come back to LA on the weekend. As for the Chiefs, they didn't plan to travel until Sunday. I spoke to a Chiefs official, and he said the only thing that changes is our plane is going to go to LA instead of Mexico. Okay?
Great. Thanks, Mike Garofalo. Appreciate you joining the show here on Good Morning Football 2 days in a row. Of course, player safety, their wellness, their health at the forefront of what the NFL is doing and making these decisions.
Yep.
So let's talk about this matchup, which still will be the most exciting one of the week, in my opinion.
No question.
What's the one thing that you guys are looking for now that it's in LA or really just between two of the high scoring teams in the NFL?
Yeah, you know, in 1972, Bobby Fischer took on Boris Spassky in
sure.
a chess match that
okay.
was legendary, that
yeah.
everyone in the world watched, Russia, U.S. Then in 84, Kasparov, you know Kasparov,
sure.
he took on Anatoly Karpov in this amazing chess match.
Go on.
Move those aside. We've got McVay and Andy Reid. This is the greatest chess match we've ever seen between two offensive geniuses, Rook. Tonight, whatever you want.
Where's Deep Blue?
Deep Blue.
He's Come on, baby.
The green-black computer. Get out of here with the computers. I want the humans. And McVay and Reid are two of the best to ever have ever done this in league history, and that is call an offense. And they're both on the same field in the season where both of them are having incredible years. I go back all the way, because I love the history, 1982, week 14. The geniuses of offense back then were Don Air Coryell
here we go,
and Bill
baby.
Walsh. This was as hyped as that game was. That game featured several Hall of Famers and Wes Chandler and Charlie Joyner and Kellen Winslow and Dwight Clark all in over 100 yards. That one finished Chargers 41, 49ers 37. Fouts to Chuck Muncy. 2 minutes left to go. It was hyped up then and it delivered. I want to see this offensive firepower from both sides deliver on Monday night in LA. Mexico City thing is a shame because that would have been really cool, but don't take away from what will be the best game of the weekend and quite possibly the best game of the year. I am so excited.
Yeah, Peter.
Best game of the weekend, possibly best game of the year, and I will say the best two running backs in football are playing in this game. So I'm looking at Todd Gurley, Kareem Hunt. How often do we get the best running back from the past year up against the best running back this year? So this is going to be a matchup where as much as we love offense, as much as we love these quarterbacks throwing the ball downfield and the big time highlights, it's going to be this right here. It's going to be who can control the ground and keep the other offense off the field. If Todd Gurley can do what he does best, which is everything in between those white lines, running in between tackles, catching out the backfield, getting screen plays, and going over the top for short yardage touchdowns, this could be the game that we see this offense for the Chiefs struggle because they're on the sideline. You control the clock, you save the game. So that's what I'm looking for out of this matchup. Todd Gurley up against Kareem Hunt.
I'm wondering if Todd Gurley steps it up a little bit given the fact that Cooper Kupp is out. That's the one thing I'm looking for from the Rams perspective, but also selfishly from a fantasy perspective because, you know, somebody's going to have to step up. I'm looking at those tight ends, right?
Mm-hmm.
Gerald Everett looked great. Tyler Higbee, both of them scored touchdowns last week. And against the Packers, when Cooper Kupp first suffered a different injury and he went out, I'm looking at a guy like Josh Reynolds. Josh Reynolds in that game, guys, scored 2 touchdowns. So it's really how does this offense step up? And I think that they will. And I believe in Sean McVay and really all the talent that they have. But I do believe it shouldn't be understated what a big part of the offense Cooper Kupp was, if even just to be a reliable option that was used, you know, as dinks, but also down the field.
Yeah.
I feel like he doesn't get the love for doing that, but I know about it because Drake showed it to me like all of last year, honestly, in his rookie season, and he's only built upon that. So that's a hole they're going to have to fill,
Drake. That's Jared Goff's favorite target.
That's his guy.
That's a big deal.
Mexico would have been fun, but it's the NFL. You can play it whenever, wherever people will show up. I'm going to look at Marcus Peters against his old team. As a corner, all you really have is your reputation, and it rises fast and it goes fast. Look at guys this year. Jalen's not having a great year. Certainly Malcolm Butler's taking his lumps. Right now, Marcus Peters needs to have a game against his old team. And who's he playing against? Of all the people that have a game against, the fastest human being on the planet, Tyreek Hill. There's also something really juicy. Marcus Peters in the offseason sat down with Michael Robinson in Culver City way, way, way months ago. And this is when the Alex Smith thing had just happened to Washington. And he talked about, tell me about this new quarterback, Mahomes.
Talk about Patrick Mahomes, man. You got a chance to go up against him a lot at practice. What are you expecting in this game, and what can fans expect from Patrick
Mahomes? I'm expecting turnovers, and I'm expecting to win.
Oh, you're in competitive mode right now. Yeah, you're expecting to get some turnovers off of.
What?
Already.
He know how to give me the ball.
You know how to get me the ball. Mahomes knows how to get him the ball.
Wow.
His teammate with the Chiefs last year will not be facing him. Guys, Marcus Peters needs to have a day. We saw what happened against New Orleans, Michael Thomas. It happens to everybody. It shouldn't happen week after week after week. Get that reputation back. I want to see him go big this week.
Mm. He's practiced against Tyreek Hill. He also gets to practice against Brandon Cooks, who's not that slow. So,
and I'll just real quick.